Hi everybody, I'm Heather, and this is an art adventure with Heather. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Heather's Art Adventure. I don't even have my jelly plate out yet. Isn't that crazy? I've got Jules with me, though. Hello, Jules.
Good morning, everyone.
I'm glad that you're here because at least that means I've got part of my life is right, so that's all that matters. All right. I'm dropping stuff. Okay, here we go. Take this picture off. Okay. Somebody tell Michael not to give me any bits today because I'm not ready for that. I'm just not ready for it. So I posted in the crafters community. If you guys are members of the crafters community, then you probably have already seen it. But I posted a challenge for the week. We're going to go back to our challenges, our monthly challenge or weekly challenges, and we'll maybe even be doing some giveaways. Wouldn't it be cool to be able to get some of these jelly prints in
Woohoo!
a package in the mail? What do you think of that?
Brilliant idea.
Andrew's here, Mary's here. So glad you guys are have made it. Thank you very much for being here. So yeah, I've got a huge stack of this isn't even all of them. There's more over here. Look at this. Look at this. Isn't this crazy? So the reason why I'm mentioning the challenge is because I asked over in the community, what do you do with a huge stack of jelly plates poles? And I don't want to just hear what you do. I want to see what you do. So I want you to share pictures of what you would do with your jelly plates. Now, you might not have a jelly plate and you might not have any poles, but you can still show me what you would do, right?
Right,
Don't you
but
think?
I wouldn't have a clue.
Oh, well, maybe you'll be inspired by what folks will post then. All right, I'm going to get out that big 8x10 jelly plate again that we've been using. Hey, BR is in the house. Hey, Richard. Oh, check this, Jules. We never tested this. Let's see. Guests can see comments. Can you see them? Here in
Where
Twitch, in our StreamYard
in
thing?
StreamYard? Yes, I
Yeah.
noticed the comments are there, but they're not coming up for me on Twitch. Rich is saying BR is here. All
Yeah.
I can see is Rich's comments in the Twitch.
Oh, you can't see Andy and
No.
Mary's comments. Well, maybe you got on there before they posted them, or after they posted them, I mean to say. I would have
Maybe.
eggs, bacon, sausage, hash browns on my plates. Got it, Richard. It doesn't really go with jelly, but whatever. Whatever. All right, so all of this mess is still here from yesterday's play. I've been working so hard on that store that I've neglected my work area. And
Well, you're trying to get it up and running, it takes time, a
well,
lot of time.
it's taken a lot of time, but you know what else it's doing? I have to move things because we live, for those of you who don't know, we live in a tiny studio apartment. So our bedroom, our kitchen. Thankfully, the bathroom is separated, but that's the only thing that's separate from our bedroom, our kitchen, our living room, my workspace.
Yeah, you live
Where,
in one room, basically.
yeah, it's just
Yeah.
one very small room. And so I move stuff in order to make like a place to take pictures. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah.
Like a photo shoot for products for the artwork and all that stuff. I made this photo shoot area. Well, in order to do that, I had to move everything over to here. So now I'm moving stuff out of my way so I can do this. Oh my goodness. Yeah, basically a studio with a bath. We don't even have a bath. We have a shower, a stand-up one-person shower. That's it. I posted a bit early, Andy says, so that might be. Now you can see those comments, right?
I can now, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Jelly is on the toast. Exactly right, Richard. Exactly right. Okay. All right, so today's prompt, for those of you not aware, we are doing 30 days of gel printing with Bridget Koopson. That's over on Instagram. I've posted this before. I was going to make a blog post about it, but let's just be real. I don't have time. So just being honest, ain't nobody got time for that. So yeah, I haven't done it. But anyway, today's prompt that she's giving us prompts every day. So today's prompt is tape. Tape is today's prompt. And so I was thinking about this yesterday when I saw what the thing was. Do you remember this mixed media tape? It's like a paper.
Oh, yeah.
With like an adhesive on the back.
Yeah.
Remove this paper backing.
Was it last year or the year before you did?
I think it was last year.
You did a video on all the different things with the thermal foil and all that, yeah.
Yeah, ooh, and I just used it again, yeah.
You did that beautiful pear picture, didn't you?
Yes, that's what it was. So we're going to use that tape. I'm sure that's probably not what she meant, but we're going to use that tape. And then I have some other ideas for tape-esque. That's a word I just made up.
Mm.
Yeah,
Jazzy joined us.
Yay, Jazzy's here as well.
But I mean, she said tape, and it is tape.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. So, all right, so here's what we're going to do. I want you guys to, like, start listing some colors you want me to use. Rich, we know you want me to use black. That's not going to happen right off the bat, so be aware of that, my friend, okay? But name some other actual colors, because typically, just so you know, technically, black is the absence of color. So when I say color, I'm asking for anything else other than black or white. Those are neutrals that we are not going to use right off the bat. Okay. So you guys, I'm going to walk over here while you put in your color choices. Did I just shut Rich down? Is he done watching us now?
He says, isn't that gelatinous?
That's what this is. Gelatinous for sure.
Yeah.
For sure. All right, let's see here.
Jazzy's saying aquas.
Aquas. All right. Yeah. I like that.
Andy's saying metallic blue with glitter.
All right. I don't know about glitter. I got metallic green with glitter. You putting down black. Not at all, my friend. Just stating a fact. It is the absence of color. All right. So we've got turquoise, aquas, metallic blue, etc. So that just pretty much Dinah right there, isn't it?
Oh,
and
yeah.
I get to use my brayer. I'm so excited. Okay. Sorry.
You did well though without the brayer.
Oh, you're a good liar, but that's all right. I did not.
You got some good pulls yesterday.
You know, watercolors with Michael says, can I ask you a question? He sent me a message yesterday. Can I ask you a question? Why were you trying so hard not to use a brayer? I'm like, it was one of the stupid prompts. He goes, but you made it. I said, it's all part of the challenge. He goes, you made it so far, almost. Yeah, almost. Isn't that true? Oh, isn't it true? All right, so let's see.
Andrew says that will do about the glitter paint.
Okay, good. I really enjoyed doing this yesterday.
Yeah.
I want one of these over here to do this on.
I love them foam stamps.
I know, and they're so cheap. I mean, you can see the price tag right here. It's $1.47. I think I found it in the Michael's bin or something.
Yeah.
I mean, I know they're not that way everywhere, but
I wish I could get out and go shopping because I miss all the deals like that.
Well, they're really lightweight. I wonder if I could sneak something into your package. I love this Dinah paint for a couple reasons, as you know.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, I love the shimmer shine that you get from that Dyna Paint, but PBO Studio acrylics have this great viscosity that allows them to stay wet a little bit longer. So we get some playtime. So that's kind of fun.
Yeah.
I like that. And you know, I wasn't up for this. I wasn't up for this, but I am today. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this apart. So I've got separate ones. Using the wrong scissors, but.
Are they worth the money, those cutter base scissors?
I've had these, like, this was the very first purchase I ever made as a crafter.
All right. So there are
this. This and my great big cutter, you know, that great big gray thing that I.
Yeah.
Those two things I bought at the same time. From. I don't remember, actually. It might have been Joanne's, now that I think about it, but yeah.
Melissa has joined us. And
hello, Melissa.
Her phone's dying.
Oh, dear. Time to have a funeral. All right, let's see. Let's just see what that gives us. Just to get started. We're warming up the plate. Warming up me is really what we're doing, but I don't like saying that because it sounds really like it's not that kind of a Twitch show. You know what I'm saying? All right. Nowadays you can be accused of a lot of stuff on this platform. I'm just saying there's a whole lot of mess with this, but we try to do something different here. I love this. That looks gorgeous.
That's gorgeous. Yeah.
This has nothing to do with tape, but you know, who cares at this point? All right. So let's do something like that again.
You could cut them hearts out with a little bit of a border, and there's your card.
Oh, true. Very true. All right, let's do that again. Well, let me see if there's even anything to pull off of here first, okay? Let's just... This is... I love when we put, like, a flat... flat matte finish paint behind all of that metallic. I love when we do that. Let's see if this is, that might be too thin, but we'll see. We'll see. I'm willing to try. How about you?
Oh, it's a lovely color mix, so I'm happy with that.
Mm-hmm.
Jazzy's saying that is beauteous.
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 Yes.
Either one of those words works for making me happy, so.
Yeah.
Oh. Subtle shimmer on the back of that. Ooh, that's purties.
It is pretty.
All right, we're going to add to that one. All right, so let's do it again. And this time we'll introduce some tape.
Where are you going to put the tape, or are you going to do it all in one?
I'll
wait and see.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. I didn't want to tell you to just not cool your jets or anything like that, so I appreciate you saying it on your own. All right, I really like that patterning, and it'll play really cool with my idea, so let's just go ahead and do the same thing. And I love stamping this off over here. I didn't use as much paint this time, I can tell already. Some marks being made. Marks being made here and there. I don't know what I did with it. Let's just use this. Ooh, that's cool. Working quickly. Getting some good marks in there. Yeah, I think so. All right. And then take our tape. And I probably should have done this ahead of time. But I'm not so smart sometimes, okay? This is one of those moments where I'm not so bright. I'm going to cut our strips. I think this will be okay because I think we're going to do another layer of color over the top of this. How many do you think we need?
It's going to take a few.
Yeah, I think you're right. How about a few more? Try to get a couple of those done. All right, so there's some tape. We still look at that roll still. Tons left on that roll. I've had this roll a long time too, so.
You have, yeah.
Yeah. All right, let's go back to that. Putting that quinacridone magenta right over the top of that.
That's going to be gorgeous.
Well, I hope so. I hope I didn't. It seemed like it was drying pretty fast, so I think I did okay. We'll see. Just layer these across. Wouldn't this be neat to use in your art journal? Or even on a card as an accent, you could stamp on these. I've shown that before.
Yeah.
You could still stamp over the top of this with some letters and have it, or even some sentiments.
It's a good idea. Camilla's joined us.
Work really well like washi tape.
Yeah.
All right. I don't know how I did that, but I counted just exactly enough. Wow.
Cool. Wow.
Every once in a while, I have a moment of like genius. I think that's it for the year, though. I don't have any more left in me.
Camilla right. Loves the color.
All right. Let's pull these off and see what we get, eh? Did I push in it? I don't know if I'm in it. Let's see.
They do go really well together, those two colors.
Mm-hmm. There's some patterning even from the brayer, because I don't know if you can tell, but my brayer has like some marks on it.
Yeah.
From the paint from eons ago. And there's some of that patterning is in.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, boy. These ones that are on here longer seem to be pulling up a little bit more. Like it soaked into the tape.
Yeah.
This is a mixed media paper that is on an adhesive backing and leaving it with, you know, these end up being pieces of tape that we can use just like washi tape.
Andrew says, okay, now waffle weave those strips into one piece.
Yeah, it's not going to happen. Not going to happen. Nice try, buddy. Like Melissa said, love the color. And yeah, that's just not going to happen, my friend.
That was Camilla.
Oh, I'm sorry. Good thing you're paying attention. Camilla said, my bad. Okay. And what does Rich say? Is mixed paper a multitasker paper?
Mixed media paper. Yeah.
Sure, we'll go with that. All right, I'm going to put some yellow on this just because it's such an contrasting color to everything that we got on there at the moment.
Yeah. Ooh, might be oranges and greens in as well.
That's kind of what I was hoping, but we'll see. I don't know. It may just make mud for all we know, but that's part of the adventure.
Yay.
Okay. And
Andrew says, I think we can color Heather confused.
Yeah, it's not hard to do, Andrew, and you know that more than anyone else does. Speaking of Andrew, him and Michael, man, bless my socks off yesterday. I cannot wait until next month, starting in October, the aim of the game being here on Daily Art Adventures is going to be all about long-term projects. So once we're done with this 30 days of gel plating, we're going to spend however much time is required of us. Now here's a bonus to using paint. Let's get back to that thought in just a moment, but look at that.
That's gorgeous.
Using tape, and now it looks like a old weathered wood.
Wow.
Like wood slats. Because yeah. We used that tape on there, left those lines. Now it looks like wood slats, all the coloring in there, a little
Look
bit of shine.
That is gorgeous.
That is an amazing print. I could not have done that on purpose, I don't think.
Nikki's joined us.
Hello, hello, hello.
And Andrew says, that is magnifique.
Yeah, I have to agree. I'm really impressed with this. We could just drop the mic and walk away right now. We're not gonna, but we could, because that's pretty awesome. I love that piece.
Gorgeous.
That one requires a picture.
Oh, yeah.
Here, let's take a picture of how we did this. We'll put some of these tape pieces down like that in our... I'm fiddling with the picture, you guys. I hope you don't mind.
Of course not. It helps us learn how to take pictures as well.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't think I take very good pictures, but...
Have you seen mine? At least you've got decent light. Mine are
well,
all
that
yellow.
Makes a huge difference. Yeah, you do have to have pretty good lighting, or at least know how to use your camera to adjust the lighting. Wowzers. Wowzers, wowzers. Okay, maybe I won't be doing that. Why isn't it? All right, we'll just go with this. I feel like technology has it out for me today, or this whole week, actually, because I've had nothing but struggles. Let's just see what happens. Will it work? Hang on, everybody. We'll see.
Okay, it's refreshing.
I'm getting this. This is what I'm getting. See? All right, let's just try it one more time. Here we go. I'm just going to send one picture at a time instead of trying to do them all. How about that? So there's that one.
Figuring that out, I'll read what Richard said. He says, I use my cell to take pictures. I put it on HDR, high dynamic range. Good idea, Richard.
Yeah, that's a good plan for right. Normal pictures, pretty good like that. Paint is different though, man. Taking pictures of these things, there's no one way to do it because of how the metallics and...
They look fabulous.
All wow. Right, they should both be on there now.
Yeah, they are.
Okay.
Yeah. Absolutely gorgeous.
All right, so that's that tape. That was fun. We can even go back in and put in some of that black that Richard likes. Put in some black marks on there. That would be really neat washi tape.
Yeah.
You know? We might do that after they're totally dry, okay?
That yellow is really bright, isn't it?
Oh my gosh, it is just an amazing print. This one I can't stop looking at it. But we have to move on. There's other things to do. So let's do this metallic teal. And I want to see what metallic teal, metallic red, and yellow will do on this plate. Let's just see what we get. Okay. And then we're going to do the next thing with our tape idea. Or my tape idea. Seriously, what did I do with the brayer? Like, how could I have lost the brayer? It's right in front of me. I know it is. Oh, there it is. See? Wow. That was just crazy. Okay. So I'm going to use the small one, spread out this yellow.
I was just going to say, I've just spotted that one that you picked up.
So I think that's a wise decision there. And then we're going to go in with the red.
Rich is happy because you mentioned the black. And then he says the brayer is a roller.
And then the blue, teal, whatever. Get a little bit of some rainbowy-ish. I think we need a little bit more of that teal on here though, because it's getting a little wonky over here. I don't like wonky. It's like I took the paint off of the plate. So, all right. All right. Here's what we're doing. See this sheet of labels? I don't use these labels. This was like a misprint or something. So we're going to paint on our labels. I know it's not tape, but it's tape-esque. See, tape-esque.
Tape-esque.
And my purpose for this is these would be really cool to be used in. Look at that. That's wicked. Keep adding layers to them and then you won't see the stuff underneath. Let's try. I've got a bunch of these.
They look gorgeous.
It reminds me of like the Jamaican flag or something. I don't know. That's kind of cool. All right. There's a lot of yellow left on there. That yellow is very transparent. Let's just see if we can pick that up. Oh, stickers. You weren't supposed to come off. You're supposed to stay on your home. Doesn't help if the stickers aren't going to cooperate with me. All right. Those are cool. And then as they dry, see all that metallic? Oh, nummy. All right, let's do some more.
Very nice.
Darker stuff. Some blue, some magenta. We'll make some. I like when it doesn't fully mix. That makes me very happy. See that? Can you see those marks in there? Looks like chicken wire.
Yeah.
It's because it's what it was on the brayer. It's like embedded in the ink. All right, so now we're going to make some marks on our stickers. So we're making homemade stickers, tape-esque.
That looks really cool.
I like that.
Mm.
So
very much.
On these. Let's see. It doesn't make much sense when they're on the sheet like that, but it doesn't have to because when you pull them off, it'll just be bits and bobs, you know?
Yeah. They're like little ATCs, but stickers with your details on.
Yeah. Let's see if we can't get some of this blue on here. That looks pretty cool.
Yeah, I agree, Rich. Bits and pieces.
So we pull this and we have another pole. Oh my gosh. And all the colors that are on this because of that red and yellow and teal.
Mm. Oh, wow.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah.
All right.
Jazzy's saying she's just decided yesterday to use her gel plate to cover a bunch of return address labels.
Exactly. See?
Just this way, she says. She's glad to see how well it's working.
See? There you go, girl.
Do look lovely, them labels. It fits in with your whole aesthetic. Is that how you say the word?
I think so. Yeah. I like a little bit of color here, a little bit of color there. Let's throw in some more of this. I like when it's when there's just a little, you know, like that. I like when it's like that.
Yeah.
All right. We're going to grab another sheet of labels. So I have some of these that are like this. I have several that are like that.
Well, the labels look like tape as well, don't they?
Yeah, that's kind of what I was thinking. I don't know. I didn't think it was cheating. I didn't think I had to ask Nikki if I was cheating.
Oh, look at that.
Seemed like it went right along with tape. That's kind of fun. Let's put some of these marks on here. I'm going to go back to this, and we're going to pull some of this stuff off. If I could only find some things to make some marks with. Like, for example, as if, we'll use this little polka dots. Nope, it's not working too well. Can't really see them. Let's see. There's a little bit of polka dots on there, but not much. So that didn't work so well, but look at that. Let's pull that. We're going to go right on top of this.
I'll be back in a sec, Heather.
You got it, sweetie. Pull some of that off. See what happens. Oh, this print is making me very happy. There's a lot going on in there. That might be fun to doodle on. We shall see. All right, let's try. Let's do some black marks. I alluded to it. Let's actually do it now. We're just going to load up this plate with black. Actually, let's do a whole layer of it. The whole thing covered in black. This will be our palette. We'll take some marks from this. Let me clean off my brayer. I always got to remember that part. I get so excited about the next step that I forget that I have to clean off my brayer.
Okay, I'm back.
All right. We will go right in here, right across these. Making some marks there. Let's move this. And Lord have mercy, what did I do with the raindrops piece and the circle? I just get so ambitious, I throw things around. I'm wild, I'm crazy. They fell to the floor, figures.
I was going to say, look up. In case you put them on your little buckets.
Can you guys see what I'm doing over here? I'm not off camera, I hope.
No, we'll see.
I have to work quickly because this black paint is drying.
Lucy's joined us.
Oh my goodness, Lucy. So very unexpected and wonderful surprise. All right, these raindrops. I got to get these raindrops because I really like the marks they make.
Nikki says you're good. She concurs with all you're doing.
Okay, excellent. Because if I don't have Nikki's approval, then I really feel like I'm cheating, and I don't want to cheat. Like, I'm up for this challenge. I don't want to negate it, you know?
No, I think it's a good idea doing the labels because they are tape. Oh, Lucy. She says, Heather, I got my ATC from you today. It's beautiful. Thank you.
Oh, wonderful. I'm really shocked by that because, okay, check the envelope and see, did I put international postage on that? Because I really thought I would get all of those back in the mail once the post office figured out that I put regular stamps on. because I made a mistake. I didn't, you know, usually what I do when I go to the post office is I take all of my domestic ones and separate them from the overseas.
Yeah.
And then I tell the person, you know, these are all domestic. These are all going to need world stamps, you know, et cetera. And I didn't do that this time. Okay. This is a favorite right here. I don't know if you guys can see all the colors underneath this.
Yeah, you can a little bit.
Oh, yum. That was fun.
Of course, Rich is happy because you're using black.
Well, of course he is. I knew he would be. But yeah, so I forgot to do it, and I fully expected I would receive all of them back in the mail, which of course they'll be shipped to Butte because that's my business address.
Yeah, I forgot about that.
Yeah, so I was like, oh dear Lord. So I'm gonna pay my PO box to ship all of them back to me, so that way I can put correct postage on. But wonderful news that at least one of them has arrived. And if you haven't received yours yet, as in Jane and Jules, for example, that is because your package is still sitting here, and I have them to go out. They just, it was, you know, because I have to go overseas. So it was taking me a little bit. So they're going out today.
Well, we'll get them when you can send them. We know they'll arrive sometime.
Yeah, I know you're very gracious with your patience with me, but, yeah. I don't deserve it because of how much I'm taken away, but that's okay. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Heather, you're a busy woman. You do a lot for very little back.
Well, I appreciate you saying that. But I have great friends who send me birthday gifts before my birthday, unexpected ones that are like amazing. I have all of you sending me wonderful notes of encouragement, and all that stuff is very important to me, and I'm grateful, very grateful. What we're doing here.
Yeah. When I saw your post in the community last night, I was over the moon because I know how much that meant to you, what Michael and Andrew have done.
Oh, totally, totally. This one isn't printing as much, but that shimmer is nice. It's a nice little addition. Let's see. Let's put some of these in here too, because that's kind of a cool. Anything that has this solid, you know, a more solid pattern to it would be nice to take off the paint on the jelly print.
Yeah.
Like that. And then it leaves these voids that are actually really kind of cool.
Lucy says she feels like it arrived mega quickly.
It only took a week. I sent it on Friday last week.
Yeah.
And it was a holiday. So that's 1 week ago today that I sent that, and we had a holiday on Monday. So that's really amazing.
It is. It's normally 2 weeks, so you've been lucky, Lucy.
Definitely the package is going to take a couple weeks. I'm sure of that.
Yeah.
When it's just a regular envelope, I think it's a little better, but.
Jazzy's waiting patiently too.
Thank you, Jazzy. Oh, that's amazing.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I love this. This is beautiful. All right. So let's mix. Let's get some purple.
Mm-hmm. I won't argue with that.
Okay. So we're going to do a little bit more of that blue magenta mixture. And then I have a surprise.
Ooh.
So we're going to mix this one a lot more than I usually do. I like to leave those blobs usually, but we'll mix it so we get more purplish. Right. And then just for kicks, let's add some of Dyna iridescent violet blue in there because we can. It gets real transparent, so that's why it's good to add it to a darker color.
Yeah.
And then it'll have that sort of sheen to it, which
like
I love.
Duochrome.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Duochrome, exactly. So let's go ahead. Let's try it on here first, see what we got.
Everyone's on about how pretty they all are.
And put it on here. I feel like we're making like masterpieces here. Check this out.
Hello.
What an addition that is.
Gorgeous.
I'm going to turn some a couple of different ways. That's making me very happy. And we'll do one more here. Like that. And then let's go in with this round bit. So we haven't done that on here. We're going to put that on these. Just adding layers and layers and layers to our tape-esque. And we'll see what they're like when we're done here. Let's add some of this to these.
They're gorgeous, Heather. Oh, on the tape itself. Oh, no, that's e-labels.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. Let's do a little bit more maybe on this one here. Adds just a little bit more to it. Trying to find our labels here, buried underneath all my mess. I'm just doing like half of it, so it's not going to have cover everything.
Yeah.
Like that.
Gorgeous.
These, I think, are my favorite. I love all that rainbow underneath, but when they're going to be individual, so you won't see all that together. So this whole sheet is awesome, but individually, it won't look like that. This one I love. I'm not messing with that. Wonder if we could add to this, but I hate to ruin it. This one I'm loving, too. I'm kind of impressed with how that one is. Let's add some of these to that. Let's get ourselves some more. Oh, yeah. I don't know if you guys can see that, but.
Yeah, just.
All right, there. Can you see that shimmer on those?
Yeah.
Barely. It's there.
Well, that's part of the attraction. You're like, did I say something there? And then you're moving it about to see if you can catch it again.
All right, here's this one that we did. We can add this to it, I think. That'll be good. Go right over, and some of it will be missing, so it'll be kind of an added layer.
Yeah.
Oh, the grunge. Oh, look at that.
Oh, wow.
That's fun. That's very fun.
Very.
Let's do a thin layer of this white to capture all the rest of this.
Try doing the yellow again.
Oh, the yellow on that purple, you think?
Yeah.
I think I did the white before you said it, but.
You did, yeah. So vibrant, that yellow one.
I love these when we do these cleanup polls.
Mm-hmm.
There's just so much going on in them, and it's like I don't want to ruin them. No one has done anything with the treasure map piece that we posted. I haven't seen anything yet anyway. So if someone has done it, they haven't tagged me so I could see it.
I've got to get my printer working.
I think I'm going to put it digitally into my iPad and see if I can't do a treasure map on my iPad.
Yeah.
In my free time, of course. That's an amazing pull. Look at that.
Oh, wow.
Look at that. And it's got little bits of shimmer shine here and there.
You did that's the a right great, thing with the white.
Look at how clean it is. Yeah. Look at how clean it is. That's awesome. Oh, wow. We should stop there, but I'm not gonna. And I'm telling you why, because I need some black on here as a palette. I'm not gonna do a whole big area, but we have our, that's good enough. We have our tape, our washi tape that I really would like to stamp on. See, that's a good idea, if I say so myself.
Oh, yeah.
Which I just did. So that. Put on. Oh, and I'm getting like some over stamps on here. Bonus. Do the leaves. I really like the leaf.
Oh. Rich is he's making comments about Kodachrome. Looks like a little rhyme there.
Look at that.
That's gorgeous.
Yeah, that's going to be cool. I don't know if you guys have noticed, if you get a package from me, I've been using washi tape to adorn the envelope. I'm going to be adorning some envelopes with this stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Love it. This one, you can see some of the heart swirl pattern. Wonder if we can do that with the black and accentuate that a little bit. Let's get it really. And then we'll also have it on our underneath paper too. Yeah, I like that. Let's do another one. We might need some more black, Richard. Might need more black.
It's looking good.
This is one of my favorite ways to use the jelly plate as a palette.
Ink pad, yeah.
Yeah.
Ink palette.
Yeah. You get so much out of it doing it that way. It works so well. I love that. That looks amazing. Let's try this one. See if that will give us anything. I'm going to turn my under paper here so we get a little bit more variation. Let's do it on this one. That needs some black. Wouldn't you agree, Richard? Yep, I thought you would.
Oh,
that's
wow.
Cool. Yeah. That's very cool. We got a couple more. We're going to do some more of that because I really like that. Yeah, that's cool. It's just a subtle pattern. And then.
Wow. Gorgeous.
There we go.
Ooh.
Pick up a little bit of that here and there. There we go. So let's take a look and see what this is like when we use it as tape.
The verse that Rich put in was is part of a song, Paul Simon one.
Add a little bit of black to those. That's kind of a good idea.
I love
maybe
them.
A little heavy. Bit. Yeah, see, now that the black is drying some, it's not as intense. So it's adding like just little marks.
Yeah.
I like
that's
that.
That's all you need on that one.
Yep. Yep. Let's just put on a little bit here. See? So it's drying up. So it's just a little bit to go on here and there. Not much.
All the colors pop that much more.
Okay, so let's see what this is like when we go on to something like this, maybe. All right, so I'm just going to peel off the back
right.
And see.
Let's see what you're going to do now, yeah.
And then we'll just go right here. There's that doily right there. So we'll just sort of make it seem like it's a part, like extended. See.
I forgot the tape was white. I was thinking it was clear.
Yeah, no, this stuff is white. But so there's the tape on our doily.
Yeah.
That's kind of cool. And then here we've got a couple of these we could use. So you could see what they're like individually.
Mm-hmm.
So these would be kind of cool to have, to use these on packages, in your art journal. Could stamp on them. Could a heat emboss sentiment on that. So that's all of those. And then we did... These will be really cool to use as little labels and stickers, almost like a little sheet of washi tape almost.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's just a label, but I love that. Let's put that one back over here on this one because that green is so cool.
You've done good.
Look at that. That's pretty neat. Anyway, so you get the idea, right?
We've got gorgeous,
several of
yeah.
these. Several of these are strips of tape. Oh, I'm very, very happy with all this. But I think the thing that makes me the happiest in all of this was this one piece right here. I think that's the piece that made me the happiest. Look at all these poles we got at doing all of this.
Yeah, it's absolutely beautiful.
There's a favorite. I think, Rich, you probably want that one framed, don't you, buddy? I've got to do something with this because this is just pretty.
They all are.
Look at that one. And all of our labels. This print is by far my favorite, though. It looks like old wood. I feel like it needs a, you know, like this is the background to signs or something.
Yeah, it just needs a few words on it.
Yeah. You'll probably be seeing this one on social media a lot. Welcome back. Live in five, you know. All right. That was fun, you guys. Thank you so much.
You can't plan for something like that with a jelly plate. Well, they're just happy accidents.
If I would have tried to make that, I don't think it would look that good. We've experienced that on here this whole week. But yeah, that's amazing with the slats. It looking like an old piece of wood.
Yeah,
you know, I didn't even get to the one tape thing that most people who do jelly plating know about, using the clear packing tape to pull stuff off.
Yeah.
I didn't even get to that. Here, let's do that one real quick. Ooh, sorry, it makes a horrible sound. Let's do that just one strip and we'll take this off. So this is what you do. Once it's all dry, you put it over the top. Let's get some of that lace pattern. Okay, you would like cover your whole thing with this.
Yeah, I've seen people clean the plates with the tape.
Yeah. And you can actually add more, you know, bits and bobs to it as far as like yellow dots and green dots and blue dots and stuff all over as, you know, whatever. And anywhere that it's clear, where there's no paint, will still be sticky. But where it's where the paint is, it won't be sticky anymore.
Yeah.
But when you do something like this, where you just have marks going through and you pull those off, see how clear, how it clears the plate. So it's still sticky on the back where there's no paint. Okay.
Yeah.
That'll make a really nice addition to the one I'm trying to get to it while I'm doing a poor job of stalling. Where did it go, you guys? Seriously? Weren't we adding labels and stickers to one sheet?
Yes.
Okay.
You've got it mixed in with all the others, I think.
Lord have mercy. There it is. Good gravy. And just like this, as I was trying to show, you can stick it right over the top, and now it has made a little addition to that there.
Oh, yeah. Very nice. Looks very, because it's the doily one, it looks like lace.
Mm-hmm. Let me put some right here. So you could layer, if you just did marks on your plate in black or white, you could layer right over the top of one of your jelly plates a second layer of tape like that, and there you've got marks on it, and you can still see through to the layers below. So kind of cool.
I've also seen people do the like a black or the colored background on the tape and then fill the sticky bits in with I forgot what it's called, mica powders, colored mica powders.
That is a great way to do it. Then you have to figure out a way to glue them on, which isn't too hard, but yeah. This way though, it sticks to it. The tape is on there. It's stuck on there. So I like this part because you can add these little accentuating marks and it's stuck on and you don't have to worry about gluing it.
Yeah.
But yeah, the mica powders is a really cool trick too, because then you get that shimmer shine and it's translucent. So you'll see all the paint marks and everything.
Yeah.
So that's pretty cool. I think we did good, you guys. I'm going to take a picture of this and post it on Instagram because this is an example of all the tape that we did. This pretty much wraps up everything we did today right here.
Yeah, you've done good. We've all enjoyed it. The comments are all saying it's been a great demo.
Very cool. I think I'm going to put on a couple more so we can see some of the other colors we use too, but we'll just do like this. See, look at how that tape. Oh, you guys can't see that very well. Look at how that tape looks.
Yeah.
That's a cool tape.
Yeah.
I like that tape.
Isn't it?
Yeah, there's a good example of everything we did today right there. So I'm going to go ahead and take a picture, post that on Instagram. Thank you, everybody, for being here. I have really appreciated you joining us, Lucy, every day that you have been able to. It's so awesome. Thank you for being here. Thank you, Rich, Jane, Andy. Appreciate you guys, all of you being here. I know Mary, Camilla,
Melissa.
Melissa's here too, and I miss, Nikki. Thank you all so much. Thank you all so much. All right, you guys, that's it for me. So thank you, Jules, for being here. You guys have a fabulous weekend. Don't forget, we have a challenge going on in the community. I don't think I ever finished talking about that, but it's there. We got a store coming. Lots of stuff happening at the Kraaft
Shop. Exciting times.
Very much so. So you guys have a crafty day. We'll talk to you all later.
Thanks, everyone.